Hello students, today we are going to talk about source and presentation of the data. Mainly we have a lot of things, means mainly we collect so many sources for representing the research protocol. We call the source mainly the name called as data. So we have different source of collecting the data in different fields. In medical field mainly we collect the data from different labs and from the records and from the survey or whatever the things. Mainly the collection of data, the definition of data is, it is a various methods by which the necessary samples or data are gathered for the study in a systemic manner depending upon need or requirement of a researcher. Mainly what the researcher purpose is to get the data and interpret the data in a tabular form for the analysis purpose. Analysis in the mainly is for the statistics purpose. There are different methods of collection of data. Mainly we have so many methods to collect the data. To get into the methods, we have different source of collecting the data. There are main three important source of collecting the data. One is experiments, survey and records. So a method of collection of data, it's mainly depends upon the other four main categories. One is observation and one more is interview method and one more is questionnaire method and one more is experimental method. These are the different method of collection of data. Observation in the sense, we observe the things and collect the data. It could be any field, mainly when you are in medical field, we talk only about the medical things. So you observe some skin structure, normally skin structure, it will be very glossy and smoothy and there is no roughness on the skin. But for an example, if you get any particular disease, for an example, psoriasis. If you see psoriasis, what will happen? There is a skin erosion with a scaly falling of the skin lids after the death. So we have to observe that particular case and we have to present that particular in a tabular form and get the data for the statistical purpose. Another example we can quote for observation method is, in case of excess of cholesterol accumulation in the body, patients may present in different signs and symptoms. Just we have to observe the particular areas of an individual and get the observation and get the information. There is one more method of collecting data, that is called interview method of collecting data. What we do here, we face to face talk to the person and get the information. So there are different features of collecting the data in interview method. Mainly we need to talk to the person in a polite manner. That is very important and essential point for any researcher to get the data from a client. One more method of data collection is questionnaire method of data collection. It is one of the reliable one, but meantime, we may get some of the biased things whenever we send the questionnaire to the client. If we don't have time, he may say to his other helper or homemaker to get it filled and send to us. That is one of the disadvantages of this questionnaire method of data. And advantage of this questionnaire method of data is, we can do postal or through the email, we can get the information. Then questionnaire method, how they develop these questionnaires, it should be a valid one. There is a scientific committee or ethical committee will be there, that sit together and they gather the information and they give the permission, yes, these are the questions should be there for questionnaire methods to collect this particular information. For an example, if you want to get the information regarding anxiety, there are set of questions, some 15 set of questions. For that, one more example, Hamilton mainly anxiety state scale. So what he does is, he has a 15 questions, for that particular options will be there, each question has 4 options. So the person who has that problem will get that questionnaire and he has to just tick it what they facing by reading the question. For an example, what is his name or what is the name of the house particular, just an example, okay. Then one more method is experimental method. In this experimental method of data collection, we do lot of experiments, then we get the information. For an example, now a patient who has got increased blood sugar level, again we have to get his blood samples and check for the sugar level. That is one type of experiments. Other type of experiment is like you get the x-ray done, so normal x-ray and the fracture of the any different parts of the body, mainly the bones we see. So we go in detail about the each one. First one is observational method of data collection. Observation is a scientific tool and a systematic method of collection of data. So the main benefits of or merits of this observational method of data collection is, there is a subjective bias is eliminated in participants. There is no individual bias who can do it observational, in case of observational method of data collection. Hence we are watching the client or subjects. Independent of willingness by respondent means the person will voluntarily willing to involve in the research, and no need of active cooperation. Here the client should not be so active in involvement. The main demerits of this observational method of data collection are limited information. So patient, as I just now I said, the person who don't have time, what he do, just he will try to hide the things and he will escape from the area. So that could be one more reason. Then one more point is some unnecessary factors or hidden factors may interfere with the observation. For an example, a person who comes having central obesity, sometimes a female patient who comes having central obesity, we may think that she might be pregnant. That could be one more. Or a patient who comes with the ovarian cancer, the huge ovarian mass is there in the lower part of the abdomen, but we may get confusion with the central obesity. These are the error may go in case of observational method of data collection. Next, interview method of data collection. It is one of the best method of data collection. There is a best interrogation between the client and the researcher. It is a form of interrogation or communication based on stimuli and response or questions and answers. There is a interaction, there is a question and answer interaction between the client and the researcher. So the beautiful important characteristic features of an interviewer, he should be very polite, honest, neatly dressed, sincere, impartial, technically well, competent, with necessary practical experience, and must be friendly with the client. That is, these are the main important points of an interviewer. Some of the guidelines for interviewer, the first one is interviewer should know the problem and well planned, prepared. Always have good setup, cool and calm. Have friendly and informal talks. Have curiosity and respect. Ask well-priced questions. Should not hurt the interview. The matter must be confidential. The confidential part is very, very important. Why? Means we cannot share whatever the client will give the information to the another client. The merits of this interview method of data collection. There is a more detailed information can be obtained, greater flexibility to restructure the questions. Demerits are some chances of subjective bias. Sometimes the client may say false, and time consuming. It is a vast time consuming. Then one more method of data collection is questionnaire method of data collection. It is a method where questions are given and the respondent is asked to reply the same according to the instruction. The questionnaire method of data collection is very, very important, and it is time saving and even to the client and the researcher. Guidelines for questionnaires. Questions should be simple, clear, understandable and related to the topic or problem. The main meaning of this one is some people may not know the particular language, so the questionnaire whatever is formatted, that should be in that particular language, so they will come to know what is there. Decide either closed end or open end or even both the types of the questions. Means the question whether it has clear specific options, whether the patient can able to read and he can do the necessary answer to this particular question. Maintain the sequence of question. This is very, very important when we are dealing with the psychological state of an individual. So their question should be very from starting, it should be simple to the complicated one, and always try to eradicate the complication questions so that it may hurt the client emotions. Questions should not be related to personal character or wealth. Questions should not hurt the person. This is very, very important. While asking, we should not get in so detail into his personal issues or family issues, or sometimes what will happen, we may get a client who is divorced. For an example, who is diverse, and we get into his deep to the personal issue, he may get hurt and he may not cope up with us properly. Avoid the use of those questions which puts too much of strain the one's memory or intellect. Merit of this questionnaire method of data collection is time saving, low cost, large sample size can be taken at a time, sufficient time to answer, best method to those who are not approaching. Demerits are can be used in only educated and cooperative patient. This is the one of the demerit of this questionnaire method of data collection. Hence, the people who are educated, only we can implement this type of data collection. Low return rates, sometimes whatever we sent like email or whatever we do, they may not respond it properly. Low return rates, especially in posting method. Then doubt about its own version, sometimes what upgradation is highly required. So, it has its own doubt about the version. Thank you.